Turn me up a little bit. Turn me up a little bit. Turn me up a little bit.
It's the Buck Bandit Podcast. It's the Buck Bandit Podcast. We in this. We in this. We in this. We in this. It's the Buck Bandit Podcast.
Yeah. You know what it is. We back here once again, live on another episode. Buck Bandit Podcast, another week. You already know what it is.
Yes, sir.
Episode 34, kicking the door. You know what I mean?
34.
You know what I mean? Charles Barkley on these bitches. You know what I'm saying?
Back.
But you know who this is. Your boy Buck Bandit Reno.
Boy Buck Bandit P.
You know what I'm saying? Make sure you subscribe, man. We always coming at you every week with the bangers.
Definitely. Every week. You already know, man. Back to back like Drizzy. Back to back.
You know what I mean? Get it. You already know. Got a good workout in the day, man.
You
feeling good, nice and chill.
Yes,
appreciate
sir.
That, brother.
Health is wealth. You can make all the money in the world. If you sick and fucking fucked up, you can't spend it.
Yeah, real shit. Real shit. Make sure y'all did taking care of yourselves, man.
Straight up. Health is wealth, brothers and sisters.
But you already know we got a hot episode coming at you today, man.
Yes, sir.
P, man, what's the first thing we gonna get into today?
Man, we getting in straight to the rumbles, straight to the beef. You know somebody always beefing. Your boy Cat Williams is trying to rumble somebody, man.
Oh, didn't see you sitting there. What you doing there, man? What you doing here? I know why you here. You want studio time. Well, lucky you. We down here during the corona times, and as long as you got your mask and disinfected, come on down, man. $40 an hour, $100 for 3 hours, $180 for 5 hours, man. Management deals, monthly deals, whatever you need. Come on down to Buck Bandit Studio, man. Now get out of here, man. Get out of here before I catch that Rona.
Man,
he trying to rumble again. I'm sick of hearing about Cat Williams.
Let's talk about who want to rumble him, though. You know what I'm saying? Ali Sadiq said he want this smoke, man.
He said he want all the smoke. All the smitted it up.
Yeah. Already know. Let me see. Yeah, make sure you.
All the smitted it up. You know what I mean? So.
Mm-hmm.
I don't want to see that joint, man. Like, I don't want to see Cat Williams get his ass whooped by nobody else. I'm sick of Cat Williams talking shit and talking his way into an
ass. First of all, what you think about that? Because, you know, Ali Sadiq funny and all that. He tells, you know what I mean, his prison tells and shit. So,
Mexicans,
you know what I mean?
Got on boots.
You know what I'm saying? You already know. You know what I mean? So, you know he been in there. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
No, I mean, not that they always matter, but at the end of the day, Cat Williams, you know what I mean, he lost to like a 15-year-old. So, it's like,
yeah. Cat Williams been booked too. What, didn't he just come home or some shit?
Yeah, but yeah, we seen him in action though, and it ain't go well for him with the kid. The kid put him in a fucking
put him to sleep
in a chokehold and shit.
Go night night, nigga.
Yeah,
go
night
night, nigga.
Now, I ain't saying it cause it's not funny, but it is because it's like you talk so much shit.
Oh, it's funny.
And a little kid just.
Oh, it's funny. I'm laughing. He got his ass whooped by a fucking preteen, nigga.
A little ass kid, bro.
That shit is fucking hilarious. Cause it's the only reason it's hilarious cause you was talking shit. You talk shit and got your fucking ass whooped.
Yeah.
It's fucking funny.
Yeah. Well, Ali Sadiq posting videos. You know what I'm saying? He challenging him. He's saying, Cat, what's up? I want this smoke. Yeah. Let's do this. Celebrity boxing, whatever.
The
let's
thing
get
is,
it.
Cat might fucking take the match just because, like,
Cat's saying he wanted to do a boxing match.
That's the only thing that's going
to
make him the fuck relevant, and he might get a couple dollars out of it, but, nigga,
I don't know, bro,
because
if Cat come out with some more jokes, people come out to see him.
Yeah,
so it's
might.
Not like he washed up. Might. He just ain't dropped nothing.
Dre say he can't get his shit together. He can't get right out this mother.
He been doing a lot of interviews lately,
can't
though.
Get right, so. Yeah, I don't want to see that, John. Nigga, that shit, it's a rid of
I
that.
I mean, I wouldn't pay to see that, no.
It's a rid of that. He can get his ass whooped.
I don't think I'd pay to. I mean, I think people would pay to see Cat in there, but.
Yeah, people definitely would. Like,
I don't think they going to think Cat going to win the fight, though.
Fuck, no. They niggas going to fucking pay to go watch him get his ass whooped. Like, real shit. Like, that shit, man. It's a bad joint.
I mean, but there's a lot of fighters
shit.
In history that made a career off of people wanting to pay to see them get their ass whooped.
Yeah.
They just didn't lose.
Yeah, my point exactly. So.
We don't know if he's going to lose, though.
Oh, yeah, he lost.
You hear me?
He lost. It's a loss.
Why? Because Mexican got on boots?
You already know. You already know. Exactly.
You already know. Well, I mean, you heard P. P don't want to see it. I would watch it if it was up for free. You know what I'm saying? I wouldn't pay to see that. For the simple fact that, you know what I mean? Like, it's Cat Williams. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like,
and that's great. I used to fuck with Cat Williams. Heavy.
I'm like, talking about in a fight. Yeah, if it was a special.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I'll watch that. But I'm not trying to watch him rumble. Like,
Nizzle.
But the crazy thing is, what if he could fight and he really had hands?
That should be fucking the craziest thing since the coronavirus, nigga.
That's crazy.
If that nigga got in there and rumbled, nigga, they would fucking blow the nation. The nation would be like, what the fuck is going on? Everybody would stay in the house again for another year. That shit happened.
Yeah. More cat fights, too. Yeah, cat fight. That don't even sound like, it don't even sound hard. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? It's about to be a cat fight. They were like, where the bitches at? Who they at? No, Cat Williams.
Exactly. That nigga run around in the fucking ring. Wow. The fuck out of here. Cat Williams, just fall back, bruh. Fall back or just do comedy shit and stop talking so much shit about everybody.
Yeah, man. Ali, don't even, you know what I'm saying? It's good promo to come at him, but don't even worry about that fight. First of all, he's not going to accept it. Yeah, he not going to accept it. And if he do, it's not going to be much of a fight. Like,
this shit is over. Done bun. Mike Tyson first round knockout, nigga.
Maybe if y'all niggas had like a shoot off or something. You know what I mean? Then anybody can win at that point.
Yeah, y'all niggas can fucking have a joke off, nigga. Like, maybe he got a chance with that.
Maybe that. You know what I'm saying? Maybe that might be a versus. Yeah, I can see that.
Best 20 jokes.
Best 20 minutes. Like, best 20 minutes. Because they do comedy.
Right.
That 20 minute set.
That's the only way it can be kind of a level playing field. Shit.
Or 30 minutes.
Cat might have an upper hand in that respect, but anything else is uncivilized. Straight up.
You already know, man. Sorry for that, man. I'm feeling woo. But yeah, man. That's crazy. I mean, we're not looking forward to it, but we're going to get to the next topic.
Nizzle.
You know what I'm saying? Nizzle. We just had to talk about it because it's what's popping right now. You know what I'm saying? It's popping up everywhere. You know what I mean? So why not address that situation and how much nobody, I think, will really want to see it.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying?
Let's talk about how it shit is something everybody does not want to see.
This next thing we're going to get into when we
skirt.
You know what I'm saying? We're going to go over to the NBA side, you know what I mean, to the sports side, and let's talk about Andrew Wiggins and his refusal to take the vaccine. You know what I'm saying?
Buck Bandit P here to tell y'all once again, fresh buck gear is in, so make sure y'all copping up on that buck gear. We got it from the adult sizes all the way down to the kids sizes, shirts, hoodies, all kind of flavors, custom colors, whatever you need. Just make sure y'all get at us. You hear the phone is popping right now for this new buck gear. So make sure y'all get at us. Follow us on the Instagram at Buck Bandit Clothing, or you can follow us on Twitter at Buck Clothing, or hit us up on that email. That's buckbanditclothing@gmail.com. You already know what it is. Let's get it.
He played for the Golden State Warriors, and basically, they have that that rule in effect where, you know, you can't go into events and shit without the vaccine.
Uh-huh.
So basically, they saying for all his home games, which is like 41 games or 42 games, plus the couple games that he got to play in against other teams who got the same rule, he can't play at all.
Right.
You know what I mean? Like, he can't even come into the facility.
Right, brother.
So what you think about him not taking the vaccine, and then, you know, the second part would be, you know what I'm saying, what you think about the fact that I'm trying to you know, put that into play.
They ain't trying to do shit. That shit,
I mean, that's only one stadium.
That shit is in full effect, nigga. Don't bring your black ass. Oh, yeah, you don't want to get the shot? Oh, yeah, stay your black ass the fuck out of here.
Even if you're on the team.
I'm not for or against the shot. Do whatever the fuck you do, whatever you want to do for you. But, nigga, you getting paid millions of dollars.
And that's the rules. Those the rules.
Rape, nigga. Yeah. So don't come to fucking. Don't bring. Keep your black ass out. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's fucked up. That's how that shit. That's how that shit being now, dog.
That's if how you ain't got the crumbles. Facts,
stay your ass back. And but yeah, you got millions of dollars on the line, nigga. I don't know. You might have to.
You gonna have to take that vaccine.
You might have to reconsider that.
You
gonna
have
brother.
To take that, bro.
That them paychecks are gonna be looking slim as shit.
I mean, he could be one of the other because he could be a person who not end up not playing and then. Be like the Kaepernick of vaccines, you know what I'm saying? But then yeah, you got to think of a life after basketball right away.
Yeah, nigga, I hope you got your Andrew Wiggins brand together, nigga. But other than that, nigga, or you got your shit already stable, like your shit already cool. Because other than that, once you start missing them checks every 2 weeks, that shit start hurting after a while. Like, damn.
It's millions of dollars on the line.
Straight up, dog. You miss half a season. I know it's some type of clause.
A little bit.
In the contract.
A couple games over half a season.
Yeah, I know it's some type of clause in the contract where you don't get paid if you don't play a certain number of games. Especially on some corona. They ain't like you hurt type shit. It's on some, no, I'm volunteer. I'm willingly not doing this shit. That, yeah, so I don't know, dog. I think that's a.
And the crazy thing is, not every team got that rule, so I don't think every player in the NBA not vaccinated, but they just don't play for a team that required it.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? But if you want to play, and you want to play for the Warriors, that's what you gotta do. You
got millions. You better get a fucking fake vaccination card, man. He probably can't do it. They like, no, nigga, you gotta be on camera taking this shit, nigga. You ain't.
No, I mean they got their people.
Who's us?
Yeah, they got their personal doctors and shit. So they gonna make sure they get the right shit. But he don't trust it just like a lot of us. So
that's a bad.
You know what I mean? You stuck between a rock and a hard place right now on some real shit. Like, what can you do? But take it.
Yeah. Take that. Yeah.
You know what I mean? And the second part was what you think about that? You think they gonna implement that for the whole NBA?
Nigga, they about to implement that shit for the fucking world, nigga. At least for the United States. They already coming out with shit saying all jobs gotta make sure they employees vaccinated, all this crazy nut shit. So
yeah,
I hope motherfuckers got their affairs in.
Well, you ain't gonna
have
no job and none of that shit.
Yeah, I hope you got your business on and popping. I hope you doing some investing. I hope you doing something, nigga, cause if not, you gonna be shit out of luck. Straight up. Or you gonna have to get the vax all in your back.
Yeah, you gotta, you know what I mean, start your own business and make your own rules. Or real you gonna be out in the cold looking like a fool.
Yeah, real shit. That you shit is about to be a bad joint. So I hope motherfuckers see the play. That's one thing we try to school y'all on. Y'all better read between the lines. You better see the play that the motherfuckers, that the people in power are putting in place. And the crazy thing is, them motherfuckers ain't getting no vaccine. That's the crazy. They like, no, y'all get that shit. Nigga.
Oh, yeah,
because
they definitely make it so Congress don't have to take
none
the vaccine.
Them, everybody who
like,
telling
yo,
everybody
what the fuck is
it?
Up with that? Like, how you going to make it a rule so the Congress don't have to take the vaccine, but everybody else got to? It's something with that, cuz.
Get the vaccine, your back. Straight up, man.
Something with that, man.
I don't
and
even
they
get
keep
in
coming out with different
ones. But they try to ban the fucking video. We ain't even gonna get too much into that because they'll
we'll get
some,
into it later.
They'll do some nut ass shit like, oh yeah, ban our video. Don't shut our shit down. Whatever y'all want to do, that's on y'all. But pay attention. Pay attention, stupid.
Yeah. They'll be watching you. Straight you know what I'm saying? It's real in the field, man.
Definitely
so
real. But yeah,
shout out to Andrew Wiggins, Andrew man. Wiggins. We don't know what you're gonna do, but you. You
see,
gonna have to do something,
Cam Newton, nigga. So you better watch out.
I mean, he one of them players that's always available. He don't get injured. Right. He consistent. And last year, believe it or not, him and Curry was the highest scoring duel.
Oh yeah.
Yep.
Yeah. I mean, I like him in the Golden State. I ain't like him no other place, but him in Golden State, he was doing all right. But
yeah, if they had Clay there, I think that would have worked out nice.
Yeah. Too bad he only gonna be there for 40 games. Don't let them niggas go to the playoffs, nigga.
No, nigga, too bad he not even gonna be allowed in the stadium to practice.
Real shit. That's a bad jump. Y'all gonna have to go to Andrew Wiggins' crib to practice and shit. Nigga, meet us at the park, nigga, so we can practice, nigga, for the away games.
come to Steph home court and shit.
Straight up.
You know what I'm saying? Something. Yeah. He might not let you in his crib without the vaccine.
Oh, no, Andrew Wiggins, no, bro.
Yeah, I got kids, cuz.
We all vaxxed in here, man. Yeah.
We all vaxxed.
Shit fucked up.
Yeah, it's fucked up, man.
Shit fucked up,
you know what I mean? Do what you gotta do, Andrew. Make your money. Get the vaccine, cuz.
Man,
you know what I'm saying? Ain't nothing else you could do.
If you want that check, better not play a game. Straight up.
But we're going to move into this next topic, man.
You already know.
This next topic, we're going to stay on the NBA and sports. You know what I mean?
Ooh, yeah.
This next topic, P, I want you to go first. Cause even though usually when you go first, you steal my picks.
Uh-huh.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, you know what it is. The kid Buck Bandarino.
Boy, Buck Bandit P.
And we the host of Buck Bandit Podcast, man.
Right,
and if you don't know, we on season 2, man. So if you ain't check us out, man, make sure you check us out, man.
Definitely make sure you check us out, man. Definitely. On all streaming platforms, get your podcast.
All right, sir. Watch the videos on YouTube.
Right,
you know what I mean? We talk about everything from entertainment, sports, man, all the bullshit going down on the social media, everything.
You know what I mean? If y'all out there doing some crazy shit, don't be doing some crazy shit, but we going to talk about
it. And definitely you can come and watch me, your boy, win 95% of the arguments too, you know, because I always know everything, you know what I mean?
No, that's some bullshit. I win all the
fucking. He definitely don't win.
Matter of fact, fuck that. I'm going first, so I can steal your picks, just in case, you know what I mean?
You
know what I mean?
My picks.
So, the question is, what players in NBA, you can pick your top five players in the NBA that you feel could have won a championship if they had a superstar, co-star like today? That's the question. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
You got me on that?
A producing superstar, because a nigga could be a superstar. Yeah. I don't mean that.
But like, you know what I mean? Like superstar. A KD or a fucking James Harden, you know what I mean? Or a fucking LeBron James. If they had one of these motherfuckers on their team,
I don't know.
You know what I'm saying? I feel like they could have won the championship. You know what I mean? A Curry, somebody that could have helped them. You know what I mean? So my top five is, you know what I'm saying?
Everybody got the GOAT.
Well,
number one
is AI.
Exactly.
For me.
You know what I'm saying?
If AI even had a half of a superstar with him, I feel like he would have won the chip easily.
He would have won eventually.
He would have won.
Whenever the Lakers broke up, he would have won. Because
honestly,
beating that Lakers
if he had another superstar in that Lakers run, I felt like it would have been closer.
Yeah,
than,
they could have won two games.
They could bro. No, man.
You realize the Lakers only lost
that but
one
who is
game
his
that
co-star?
Whole playoffs.
But who is his co-star?
It don't matter. The
AI
Lakers,
had nobody.
The Lakers won. I mean, the Lakers lost one game that whole playoffs, and that was against AI.
But that was AI by himself. Yeah, so imagine for those other games, they could have got the attention off
they
AI.
They had three more superstars.
So you telling me if KD or LeBron played with AI, they wouldn't have beat the Lakers.
No,
man, that's
because
you're a Kobe
brother.
Fan.
Nobody beat the Lakers.
It don't matter.
Nobody beat him. I'm not a Kobe. Nobody beat him.
You're saying that, but that's because AI didn't have
he
a superstar
had
co-star.
Jason Kidd bringing the rock up.
No, Jason Kidd wouldn't have fit.
He could have had fucking.
I just gave you somebody.
LeBron,
KD, Curry,
and Kobe.
Nigga,
and
it would have been a wrap.
Kobe and Shaq would have bust they.
No, fuck
ass.
You. That's my pick. I'm saying he would have got a chip.
None of that.
All right.
After
my
Lakers
number two.
Up, for sure.
My number two, before you start trying to hate and pick my shit apart, even though you agreed,
but no,
AI.
Yeah, he definitely.
All right, devil's advocate, man.
Eventually.
You know what I'm saying?
Like around over.
My number two is Charles Barkley.
Oh, for sure. Sir Charles.
You know what I'm saying? I wasn't there to see all of his games in the beginning, but I seen enough at the end. No, even at the end. Well, no, at the end, he did have somebody. So, more like around his son's time. If he would have had another superstar on the Suns with him, he would have at least got one.
Yeah, he would have got one eventually. He probably just snuck one in when Jordan left. But yeah, Barkley definitely would have got a chip.
So that's another one I feel.
For sure.
Number three, T-Mac. I feel like if T-Mac.
If he ain't get hurt, he could have fucked.
Yeah. But the times that he wasn't hurt when he was. The, like when he got like 30 points in fucking 13 seconds and some shit like that. Nigga. You know what I'm saying?
Fucking 30.
It wasn't 13 points. But it was like 13 points in like 5
T-Mac
seconds.
T-Mac was a fucking.
You know what I'm saying?
Though.
But
niggas forget about Mac.
If T-Mac around that time where he was going ham had another superstar co-star that can like score like him, oh yeah, he would have snuck one in.
Yeah,
that's
T-Mac,
me.
T-Mac was
that's from me.
Mac. Yeah, Mac.
Number four.
But no, I don't know about
you
that.
You know what I'm saying? CP3.
Oh, for sure. Guaranteed.
Listen, if CP3. It's a couple years. Like, the Clippers was good, but nobody else was a superstar. Guaranteed. You know what I mean? Let's
that's
just
why
that
I said
straight.
A producing
Blake
superstar.
Was supposed to be.
Because he had James Harden. Like, don't forget about
when?
That. When he was in Houston.
Well, he got hurt. He could have got that shit.
That's what I'm saying.
He was in a perfect.
James Harden is just a fucking
no,
bum.
But if you remember that series, the Rockets was going to win if Chris Paul didn't get hurt.
Yeah,
he was getting in stuff ass that Damn, series.
James Harden's a
he bite. Got hurt, that took it all away. You know what I'm saying? CP3 is another one. He,
sure.
You know what I'm saying? I feel like he could have snuck one in, whether it was his Hornets years or his fucking Clipper years. He could have got, or even that 1 year with the Rockets, he could have snuck one in.
Yeah, I think they were there 2 years. He was there
you know what
2 years. And fucking James Harden keep fucking laying donuts.
And my last one, you might disagree, but I felt like if he stayed on this shit and he got another superstar, he could have did some damage. Gilbert Arenas.
Oh, yeah, Gilbert was a beast, but he wasn't getting no trip, no.
I feel like, look, I feel like this is me, dog. It's my list. Don't hate on my list, nigga.
Too many beasts at the end of
the list. All right, I'm going to hate on your whole list. Fuck you.
My list, like, you know, damn near the same as yours, except two different niggas.
You know what I'm saying? So Gilbert Arenas is my last
Gilbert
one, man.
Arenas
go ahead, take yours.
Gilbert
take
Arenas
off.
Was a beast, but no, he wasn't getting no fucking chill.
Take off. That's what I said.
Nice
I said it.
At that time.
No
yeah,
chill,
I,
Gil. What up?
I got AI. I definitely had Barkley in there. CP3, of course, because James Harden's he's a superstar, but he's not a producing superstar. If Carmelo Anthony had a superstar.
Oh,
if Carmelo Anthony had a superstar.
He got one this year. So we going to see. So we going to see. So you got to come up with a different one because he still got time.
Yeah, he still got time. But
CP3, he ain't got no more time. Suns ain't getting there no more.
he's done.
Unless he come to the Lakers.
If Steve Nash would have had a fucking second superstar, he might have fucking around.
Steve Nash didn't get one with the Mavs?
No.
That was Jason Kidd.
That was Jason Kidd. Yeah.
Exactly. And he ain't get one with the Suns.
Nope.
He got the MVP.
He got the MVP 2 years in a
oh,
row.
Oh, no, he did have a superstar.
Western Conference Finals. Who?
Stephon Marbury. Starberry.
Like I said, if Steve Nash would have had a superstar.
You hate Starberry? Go to China, nigga. Say that in China.
Yeah, Amari Stoudemire. No, yeah. If he would have had a superstar, he could have won a chip.
No, not Amari.
Yeah, Amari.
I'm talking about Starberry.
I don't think they play at the same time. And even if so, like I said, if Steve Nash would have had a superstar, he would have won a chip.
All right, he a hater.
An honorable mention, though. If Embiid would have a fucking second superstar,
he
they
had
won
one.
The chip.
He had one.
2 years
and that
in
nigga folded
round.
Like
they
a motherfucking
beat
laptop.
The Raptors and they could have beat the Bucks, but Embiid don't have a fucking second superstar. That's bullshit.
Well, he folded
That's
like a motherfucking
head.
Laptop. He
folded like a motherfucking.
So he did have another superstar.
Picnic, bum ass. You know he mean? Didn't have.
Nigga
a,
folded
like
a motherfucking
said,
kindergarten
if
folder.
Embiid had you know a second superstar. He would be a champion already.
That nigga folded That's like a brand new t-shirt bullshit. In the packaging. You know what I'm saying?
That nigga, man. Softer than drugstore kind. But we ain't getting to that. But
that
yeah.
nigga folded like a sheet before
that
you put
my,
it in the
that
closet.
Was my honorable mention. Melo, if he had a superstar. Steve Nash, honorable mention MB, because he ain't had no superstar ever. Fucking bullshit. And you heard it here first, goddamn
yeah.
it.
Yeah, because that nigga definitely folded like a flip phone. I could go all day with this shit.
This nigga talking about he ain't even playing, but we ain't even gonna get into that. That's a whole nother fucking podcast.
Yeah.
Fucking
yeah, we already talked about it, but it's like you want to talk about it more and more because it's still happening.
This nigga talk. How you ain't gonna play, bro? I'm explaining to me to that. I explain to me how you ain't gonna play. You ain't gonna play? So you just like, no, man, I ain't playing.
I'm gonna sit out.
I ain't gonna play.
I still ain't gonna work on my shot. Now. Now. The joke's on you.
Yo, I don't like ball, man. I really don't like
He was
ball,
my man
dog.
Until, you know what I mean?
Don't like him, dog.
I'm sorry, man.
I had to bring that up. Like, this nigga, man.
I can't fuck with Ben no more, bro.
Could've won the chip twice. Like, Philly could've had two. The Eagles won. The Sixers could've won the joint. Like, we could've been popping from the year 2010 to 2020. Like,
it was 2 years. It was 2 years we could've won the chip.
Right.
The first year when they let Kawhi hit the magic shot.
Because we had to beat the fucking Bucks. Then we had to beat the Warriors.
Because everybody got hurt. Then we would've definitely got this last chip.
Because everybody else was hurt.
Everybody
nigga.
Got
we'd
hurt.
We had to beat the Bucks and we had to beat the Suns.
Bucks can't fuck with us because Antetokounmpo wasn't doing that shit to Embiid.
He ain't doing that shit to Embiid, dog. But if Embiid had a second superstar, he'd be a champion by now. Fucking bums. It's bullshit.
I mean, he ain't done playing yet, but I still take your submissions. You naming people who still playing. I named one person that was still playing, but... He re-signed with the Suns.
Yeah,
so we know they ain't getting there again.
He's
yeah.
a done by, nigga. All roads through the chip is going through L.A., nigga.
All roads lead to LeBron and Melo.
And Russell was. I was going to say Russell, but he going to get one now. Right?
Melo is going to spot up and be three city. Like I on some real shit, with all the team moves, this is probably going to be the most exciting year in a long time.
Yeah, this is going to be a good jump.
Lakers I really want to see how a lot of these teams games. Play together.
Yeah, I do too. Yeah, I do too, but it's a bad joint, man. It's a bad joint.
I mean, Sixers, we ain't far away. We just got to do something. Hopefully, we can get Dame or Bradley. Something. I'll take Bradley Beal. I'll take fucking De'Aaron Fox.
Something.
You know what I'm saying? Give us one of them. We golden. We right back where we supposed to be.
But them niggas don't. They like, what? Man, don't want that bum ass nigga. Y'all want who for him? Listen, dog. We got a pack of peanuts and some pretzels for y'all. Like, y'all. That's what the fuck this nigga's worth. He fucking. Oh, he's a hoagie. He stinks.
Zip him up.
Sick of bull.
Zip him up.
Zip him the fuck up, man.
And before Damn. We get into this, to the other half. You know what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
I wanted to throw this at you because we both was thinking about this shit. And I wanted to know how the fuck did people get around before GPS, dog? Before Google Maps. How did people know where the fuck to go?
Niggas just got lost, nigga.
My shit drop out, nigga. Of course, before this, we printed out the directions, tried to follow the directions.
Bullshit ass MapQuest.
But I'm saying before the MapQuest, before the navigational MapQuest system. Because,
yeah,
you know, we had the little navvies. They used to come solo,
the
though.
The real GPS, right.
Yeah.
You had to put that shit up on the dash in your car. And
yeah,
shit,
that
like.
Was it was separate, like, so separately.
Where you at? 123 Main Street? All right, nigga.
Hey, don't let that shit die. You know what I mean?
Yeah, no, niggas ain't getting, niggas got lost. Niggas got in the car and just drove. Nigga, listen, dog, we gonna make it there eventually, dog. We gonna make it there. Niggas just was getting lost. That's all that was. Like, I don't know, nigga. I remember
getting lost a couple of times before.
I remember getting everywhere, though. That's for damn sure.
I remember getting lost, but I remember getting where I had to go.
Nigga.
I remember having to print out the paper, like, all right, left turn on this, that.
Niggas really had to read signs and shit, nigga. Shit. Listen, get on the highway, and when you see that sign that's going remotely to anywhere you're trying to go, just follow that, John.
Yeah.
Like, yeah, that's a crazy joint. I don't know what these motherfuckers would do now if they ain't had GPS. These kids now, they don't know shit. They don't know how
shit,
to spell
these kids,
shit. They
nigga,
don't know how to
I don't be
nowhere.
Knowing where the fuck to go.
They don't know nobody's phone number. Like, you don't know shit now,
yeah.
Nigga.
Yeah, because I used to know a lot of
damn,
different people's
phone numbers. Phone number by heart. Just, oh, yeah, 215.
You couldn't even ask me.
4669. Nigga, oh, yeah, that's my homie. Like, now, I don't even know you. How you niggas don't even know their girl number. Like, oh, I don't know. Let me check.
Just hit her name, cuz. Just say call Rachel.
Nigga get locked up. Like, yo, CEO, can I get my phone? I don't know nobody's number, nigga. Hey, the fuck?
Yeah, real shit.
Yo, that shit is crazy, dog. Niggas don't know shit now. Smartphones,
yeah.
They made niggas dumb. It's some bullshit.
It definitely did. It definitely did. The smarter your technology got, the less energy and time you use real with shit. Your brain.
I don't gotta learn how to spell shit, nigga. I type that shit up in notes.
Soon
yeah.
as you start, as soon as you auto-correct. Type the first three letters,
nigga, it's gonna be three different words that pop up.
Oh yeah, that's
up.
The one. That look like the one right there. I ain't gonna lie, it's been a couple fucking words I looked at and I'm like, oh shit, that's how you spell that? Oh shit, I've been spelling that shit crazy this whole time.
That shit is
and
real.
Nobody corrected me, which means they thought that shit was correct. They just as dumb as I'm me and shit.
Yeah. That shit is crazy, dog. That shit is some funny ass shit. But yeah.
But that's a little something I wanted to know. Like, that's crazy, like.
Yeah, I don't even know. I don't even know, nigga.
I mean, we basically said it. Print out directions before that. It was like somebody telling you where to go, and
that
you just going.
Yo, man, how you get the... Stopping listen, at the man, gas station. You go up there, you make a left, you make a right.
Make
go
a right
there,
at the 7-Eleven. You going to go about eight lights down. You going to see a motherfucking diner. Don't go past the diner because you going to cross the bridge.
If you went past the diner, you went too far.
You going to go, you going to see six... So, P, this next thing we about to get into is, you already know what it's called, kill time.
Kill
you know
time,
what I'm saying?
Kill time, kill time.
You already know. We killing it. You know what I mean? Or y'all killing it. You know
or
what I'm saying?
This nigga was about to kill somebody.
Somebody was about to get killed.
Somebody about to die.
You know what I'm saying? We know that. And this the week's kill time is when the man comes into his house.
Uh-huh.
Shit, door unlocked.
Uh-huh.
He pull out the burner. What's up? Surprise, nigga, it's a surprise birthday party, motherfucker. You can-
oh, no! Can't surprise no gangster.
Look,
you can't drive surprise a thug, nigga.
Look, on some real shit, he was ready. Yeah, as y'all can see in the video. You know what I'm saying? Those of you who's listening in on the podcast, check out the video on YouTube, search Buck Bandit Podcast.
But if y'all listening, we going to explain it.
Listen.
The nigga, what
he
happened?
He walks in the house, he pull out the burner because people jump out, they yell surprise. He hurry up and put it away, tried to sneak off and hug people. All like, oh shit. Man, I almost killed all y'all. This is an automatic.
Nigga, I was going to come in.
It's a brrrr. Nigga. Somebody was about to.
What PD say in the Mac go ring?
Yep. Someone please call 911. Somebody was about to go down, cuz.
Oh, man. You know what I mean? That's funny. That's when surprise birthday goes wrong.
Yeah, and that brings the question to me, like, where is it good to throw a surprise birthday party? Because it's like, you got to get into somebody's house. They know they live alone. And
yeah, nigga, you better
they door it. Open. Lights off, you jump out. That's prime shoot me
situation. Yeah, you better do that shit
like,
at a fucking event center or something, nigga. Like, yeah, we just go on here chill for a little bit, man. Yeah. Let niggas just surprise and jump out there, and you surprise at my house with the lights off, door open, and all that. Nigga. You like, I'm coming out the burner out from the rip.
Real shit. Soon as you come, you like, what the? What the fuck? Up.
Like, I would have fucking
pull that shit out.
Somebody.
Oh
from the
yeah.
Rip.
You gotta watch. You know what I mean, you gotta watch how y'all moving out here, man.
Yeah, that's a crazy joke.
He almost caught a case by mistake.
Right. Really about to be kill time for real, nigga.
You know what I mean, that remind me of the motherfucking Key and Peele mob skit and shit. When he was Paulie, he walked in and shit, and he said, "Man, just come in." And he said, "But man, all the lights off." He man said, "Would you just walk in? She's probably taking a nap." He walked in and shit, and people went to jump out to yell surprise, and he just started shooting everybody. Bap, 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 bap. Right, so, that shit real, man. You can't be, you can't do that to everybody, man.
Yeah, fuck no.
So that was a good one. You know what I mean? Good little kill time, man. You know what I mean? Be careful out there. Be safe.
Right. Don't be jumping out on niggas.
You know what I mean? This next thing we gonna get into.
What's that?
Unforgettable moments,
yeah,
my brother.
Unforgettable.
You already
right
know. This unforgettable moment is what, P?
is fucking Dame Dash and Cameron Giles on Bill O'Brien. I had to say the nigga whole name. On the Bill O'Brien joint.
Bill O'Reilly.
Bill O'Reilly,
How do you hurt children by promoting to be an entrepreneur and a CEO and to do right?
Looking at a principle.
Why
you're looking at a principle.
Why you don't want to let him talk? You mad. Where'd you start? Current affair, right?
No, wrong.
Well, you're looking at a man. I got dirt on you, doggy.
Cameron,
I'm going to get at you in a minute.
You go ahead. You get at
me. I'm going to get at you in a minute.
You're looking at a guy who teaches inner city kids and who's telling you face to face that he has problems with kids based upon a rap music, and you're rationalizing it all up and down.
I thought you were going to mediate.
I am.
No, what you're doing is you're giving opinions. You're not an objective mediator now, Bill.
It's my program.
Bill, now it's your program.
Bill. Yes, my program.
Yo, like, what did they think was going to happen when they bought them niggas? They knew what them niggas was going to do.
At that time, man, but I don't, on some real shit, I don't think Bill O'Reilly even looked up who they were or even listened to their music and nothing.
That nigga, though. He raps about, bitch. What did he say? He raps about
the four-letter word. The four-letter word. He raps about the bitches. It's like, yo, listen, bro.
Yo, that shit is fucking hilarious.
He said, the shit that got me is, he like, I got dirt on you too, doggy. I'm going to get at you. He said, all right, well, you can get at me.
No, the funniest joke, when he was like, you mad? Like, nigga, you mad as
He definitely
shit.
Had the mad soul face on.
He was mad as shit, dog. Salty as shit, dog. What you thought, they wasn't going to come up there and fucking expose this shit out, y'all niggas? Like, dog, you ain't going to put this shit on me, nigga. Like, these niggas don't watch fucking murder ass movies and all this crazy shit and all that. Nigga, raise your fucking kids. I ain't got nothing to do with that shit.
Yeah, on some real shit. Like, it's a gift and a curse, because it's like, yeah, they got followers, but
yeah, they got
a they voice. Been like this when they got the followers.
Right.
So the people that's following them are following them because of what they're saying.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, if it's conscious rappers out there, then expose your kids to the conscious rappers. Like, stop letting them watch.
And on top of that, like Cam said, like, I'm reporting what's going on in my hood. And like, if you don't get mad at the news reporter for reporting bullshit, so don't get mad at me for reporting the bullshit.
Real
like,
shit.
If bullshit wasn't going on, then I wouldn't have no shit to say. So fuck y'all.
At the end of the day, it's circumstances. If you don't want hip-hop rappers, you know what I'm saying, to rap about the shit they rapping about, then help change the circumstances, motherfucker. Exactly. You know what I'm saying?
Other than that, niggas only gonna rap what they know and rap what they see, nigga. Fuck you talking about. Like, I ain't mad at them. Raise your fucking kids, nigga.
And that's a topic that can be forever.
Right.
That's a topic that
forever,
be. This is a throwback, unforgettable moment, and we can talk about it as if it was today's, because it's almost the same shit.
Definitely the same shit.
Even though today a lot of the rappers do rap about fucking getting fucked up and taking drugs and shit.
Yeah, that's a bad
getting
job.
High and popping pills and all that shit.
That's a bad
And drinking
job.
Syrup.
Yeah,
you know what I mean?
So.
In the E. In the weed. You know what I'm saying? I sound old as shit.
I'm looking for that weed. I'm looking for
shit,
that
shit. Me too. Where that shit at?
What are we talking about?
Is you hoeing? Get the fuck out of here.
Get on your bike and get the fuck on, Bart Brzezinski. Oh, that's a classic.
That's my shit. How high?
Oh, man, that's a classic. But yeah, that was a classic, unforgettable moment. Nigga, you mad. Fuck out of here.
Real shit.
Doggy.
I still don't like Bill O'Reilly. Like,
fuck no, nobody like.
Yeah, it's
Bill
crazy.
O'Reilly,
this motherfucker is still on air, bro. He's still on air. Like, after
still
all these years,
shit.
All these years of being an asshole, he's still on air. Like, it's
still
really a crowd that really loves what he says.
I don't see how.
I see how them good old boys.
Right.
Shit.
Exactly, the Tiki Torch boys.
The Tiki Torch
squad.
Tiki Torch Tasmanian Toothless. I don't know. I was, you know what I mean? I was almost there. The pause was too dramatic. But let's get into the next thing we're going to get into. And every week we do this because we like to shine a light on the people who really doing their shit out here, who we watch. You know what I mean? and yes, who sir. Always making moves. They like they not they never pigeonholed it. You know what right. I'm saying? They making keep that moves. Shit moving.
Making moves. You know what moves. I
mean? And this week's All-Star Spotlight. You know what I'm saying? This week it goes to
the one, the only,
Chris Broussard.
It's the Buck Bandit Podcast. Hey, it's the Buck Bandit Podcast. Hey,
you already know. Sorry,
you already know. Shout out to the OG, man.
Shout out to the OG. He definitely showed us love. Yeah, he definitely doing his thing, man. Like, you see him everywhere on he ESPN. He's one of the only announcers
I really fuck with. Yeah. Like, I fuck with a few announcers. He is one of the reporters who be reporting on shit, and he don't be. Going to
he don't co-sign everything. Right. He not a fucking yeah, I mean. And he not a hater like Stephen yeah, A and exactly. shit. Co-signing
he don't be hating
that.
On it. He don't be going too hard. He be keeping that shit all the way a buck, and that's why I fuck with him.
Yeah,
man.
It's something about that shit all it's something about the commentators that when you could go to them, you all even if you disagree with them. You can still see their points. Exactly, you know what I'm saying? Exactly. It don't make you be like, man, I fucking hate this dickhead, man. We should just stop talking. Man, you don't know straight shit up. About basketball.
Most people don't know shit about boxing. Yeah. Straight you know up. Like, but that shit real. Like, I fuck with Chris Broussard, man. He definitely give his opinion in a way where you don't be like, oh, yeah, I don't fuck with this nigga. Yeah. Like,
yeah, and he everywhere. Yeah, you know I mean? He had everywhere. Lost his spot for a minute and then just got another spot. Uh-huh. He back on the air, and you know what I'm saying? Even though in between spots, him and Rob Parker was doing their show. Right. You know what I mean? So, right. Shout out to Chris Broussard, man. Keep shout doing out. Your thing, man.
Yes, sir.
Shout out to you for checking us out, showing us love. You know
yes,
what I'm
sir.
Saying? Keep doing know. Your thing, man.
Keep going.
You already know,
you
man.
You already know.
We got to show love every week to the people who definitely show love to us.
Right.
And the even people who deserve it.
Yeah,
if they don't show love... Then, you know what I'm saying? We still watching. You know what I mean?
We still going to show love. So
we still going to do us. You know what I mean? You regardless. Doing you ain't going to stop us from doing us. You know
facts.
What I mean?
Facts.
So, big facts. What's this next thing?
Last one. Oh, no. We got two more drinks. Mm-hmm. We got things I never knew.
Things.
I never knew.
So, this week, things I never knew. Did you know, Pete, did you know, because I never knew this, but maybe you knew this shit. It's a place in Africa, Mali and Chad, mm-hmm. where they worship crocodiles.
Oh, shit. They worship crocodiles?
They worship them. They worship them. These are the motherfucking lords of the earth right here. They worship crocodiles. They have a certain belief in them. Because, you know, there isn't a habitat where they're not even supposed to be able to survive there.
Oh, shit.
So, you know, if the people watching, I mean, if the people listen, if you tune over to where we watching it at, you know what I'm saying, you can see their feeding the crocodiles. Like, there's no barrier, nothing. They just up on them, feeding them meat and shit. Like,
oh, yeah, they tripping on that.
Man, yeah, they worship them.
What the fuck we worshiping a crocodile for? That shit... That's some weird ass customs, but yeah, more power to them. But I ain't doing that shit. That's for damn. Yeah. That's for damn.
They
sure,
not kneeling
man.
Before me, shit. I know that. Bite they motherfucking heads off.
I bet you they fucking throwing that shit in the fuck out of there. Like, all right, we out, nigga. Y'all, geez for that though. But yeah, that's crazy how they not even supposed to be in that section of that area, or whatever, and they really surviving yep. there. That's
Mali and Chad.
That's
in
some
Africa.
Crazy ass shit. Some divine intervention.
They
shit,
they don't know how they got over there. Of course, there's myths and some different stories of, uh-huh. you know, what I mean, how they actually got there. But all in all, they treat them like they fucking, like I said,
like
they worship
pets
them.
And shit. They going
not kill. Pets, nigga. This they worship them. So they car, fucking
man. Time to you know go. What I mean? Time to go salute to the kings.
Yeah, real shit. Real shit.
Shit is crazy.
Which got me thinking, on the same YouTube I seen where in another country, I'm not sure if it's China or whatever, they feed the crocs and then they fucking kill them. They skin them.
Oh, shit.
You know what I'm
and
saying?
Nice ass shoes out there.
They feed, they eat them and they, you know what I mean? They feed, they fatten them up and then... They kill them and feed them.
That's
and they big ass crocs, bro.
Damn.
Big ass.
I ain't you know fuck mean? With no damn crocodile. Fuck.
Zip tie they mouth. They step them in, zip tie they mouths. You know what I'm saying? So they can't, you know what I mean? Then they zip tie their arms and shit. They little tiny arms.
Little ass
arms. Yeah, they zip tie the little tiny arms and shit. Yeah.
Yeah, that's crazy though. I definitely ain't know that. That's some crazy ass shit. That's some crazy customs we got
that's
out here in this world.
That's definitely something.
I never knew.
We never knew.
Never knew.
You know what I mean? But there's a lot of crazy customs out here. I've been seeing shit like them, how they kill octopuses where they fucking chop off the brain part and then the legs, the tentacles and shit still be moving.
Yeah, and they be
and even when
shit?
They chop it up, those tentacles still be moving. Then they rip the skin off, the tentacles still be trying to slide off the motherfucking board.
Only thing I eat that move is lasagna and jello.
No, after
nigga.
They cook, they chop them up so small. Like, they don't be moving after that.
No.
But, yeah, that shit crazy.
No.
That's crazy, man.
It's fucking crazy as shit, and I ain't doing it.
You wouldn't try it? $100,000.
I was ready to say, now how much you paying me?
$100,000.
Oh, yeah. Let me get some of that octopus over there. Right now. You fucking talking about?
You going to eat that octopussy.
$100,000. Right now. You
so any ladies out there with that octopussy, you know my nigga P got the beanski for you. Yeah. You know what I mean? And we know the going rate is $40. So you better do something extra. You know what I'm saying? Don't just give them the squigglies. You know what I mean? You already know.
The squigglies.
You know what I mean? So before we get out of this joint, we going to go into this last thing. You know what I mean? Got to wrap it up.
Yes, sir.
P, we going to give them something
wrap
to watch.
It, though.
Every week, you know what I'm saying? We got to give y'all something to watch. You know, we like tuning into a lot of different things. Maybe you can
for
get
sure.
information. Maybe you can get laughter.
For
maybe you
sure.
can get, you know, I don't know, some tragedy. You know what I mean? You might be typed into that crazy shit. You never
right,
know.
You might be in that.
Depending
shit.
On what we watching. But Pete, let them know what you watching this week, man. Something to watch.
This week, man, I'm tuned into the Millionaire's Mindset podcast.
Ooh.
Yeah, that's a good joint. You know what I mean? Y'all might want to
I mean,
check
that sound like it's a good
you
joint.
I mean?
You know what
shit,
I'm saying? My
man.
Mindset is million. What's going
that's
on there?
That's what I'm saying. So if you're trying to get on that Millionaire Mindset, you know what I mean? Check out the Millionaire Mindset podcast. The host, Xavier and Deanna, they doing their thing, man. So y'all might want to check them out, man. Right
okay.
there on the tube. Or y'all could, wherever y'all get y'all podcasts, tune into them. Always gotta show love. Anybody I fuck with, anything I'm watching, I'm going to definitely let y'all know about it. So
yeah, yeah.
Make sure y'all
I
check
mean,
that out.
Listen. It's a role for all of us.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So we not the type to watch shit, hold it to ourselves, keep the information, keep the... No, we
right
spread
now.
The love. You know what I mean? It don't hurt us. It don't hurt nobody to show love. It don't hurt to like,
man,
comment, or tell a person...
That shit is free.
You know what I mean?
Show
it's
love,
free to
nigga.
Show love. Honestly.
Free 99.
Make sure free 99, bitch.
Check out the Millionaire's Mindset pod.
Yeah, check it out.
What you watching this week? What you got on your...
This week? Yo, listen, I've been into it. I've been watching it. You know what I'm saying? It's definitely fire. It's called Wu-Tang and America. Let me say that again.
It's called what? Nigga,
Wu-Tang,
what is it called, nigga?
And American Saga. You know what I'm saying?
Yo, yeah,
so it's basically like,
fire.
You know, the story of Wu-Tang and shit like that. They coming out. It's coming out in parts. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
like Empire and all that shit. You know what I'm saying? They trying... Yeah. You know what I mean? Because NWA, they just crammed everything. Like, that's something that I feel like the NWA movie should have did.
They definitely could have came out with parts of that.
You know what I mean? But Wu-Tang capitalized off that. And what I've seen so far, good. So
yeah.
far, so good.
I
so,
heard that shit fire.
Yeah, it is. So definitely, fire. You know what I mean? Check out Wu-Tang and American Saga. You know what I mean? Check that out, man.
Yeah,
sure. There's been a lot of different reviews about it, about, you know, certain parts being factual, non-factual, whatever. But look, it's a fucking show. I don't care. As long as it's the shit good, it's good.
Exactly.
You know what I mean?
Exactly.
And I like the boy who played ODB in that joint.
Yeah.
I ain't gonna hold you.
I heard yeah. he was a boy in that joint.
Yeah, yeah. ODB was a boy. Rest in peace, man.
Right. You already know. Rest in peace to the OG.
But yo, this been another show, man. Right. Another hot episode. We keeping the bangers coming every fucking week.
Yeah,
you know
right.
what I'm saying? It's been episode 34.
Make
sure y'all subscribe.
Subscribe.
Go listen in on the podcast. So Anchor, Spotify, Apple, wherever you can get your podcast Check us out. You know what I mean? And if you listening in, first of all, if you're listening in and you ain't subscribed to the listening, you drawing. You know what I mean? Hit the subscribe right there. And if you watching us, the subscribe button right there below.
It's right there, nigga.
It's right there. Just hit the shit. You know what I'm saying?
Make sure you hit the bell.
You get the notification first.
Get the notification every time we, you know what I mean?
Upload. Every time we put up another clip, another episode. New videos coming soon, me and P.
Yes, sir.
You know what I'm saying? Like,
y'all stay tuned.
The train don't stop. Just stay tuned, man. We got a lot of guests coming soon. You won't be surprised at what we pull out soon, man.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So it's been another hot episode, man. It's your boy Buck Bandit Reno.
Your boy Buck Bandit P.
Let's get it. Buck. Wind it back.
Act like you mean more than my grind or something. Act like you been on my mind or something. Yeah, little bitch, you a dime a dozen. She